The problem on the right is from our textbook. It says, packaging. Joe's confectionery puts together two prepackaged assortments to be given to trick-or-treaters on Halloween. Assortment A contains two candy bars and two suckers and yields a profit of 40 cents. Assortment B contains one candy bar and two suckers and yields a profit of 30 cents. The store has available 500 candy bars and 600 suckers. Our job is to go through step by step and analyze what inequalities can be written and what equation can be written to maximize their profit. Part A, fill in the following chart. Confectionery A has two candy bars and two suckers. It yields a profit of 40 cents. Confectionery B has one candy bar, two suckers, and yields a profit of 30 cents. The store has available 500 candy bars, 600 suckers. Part A is finished. It will help us come to part B. Let X be the number of A assortments. That means where we have assortment A, we're going to be using variable X. And Y be the number of B assortments. Referring to the chart, give the two inequalities that X and Y must satisfy because of the availability of each confection. So assortment A, there are two candy bars needed for it, and for assortment B, there's one candy bar with at most 500 available. The inequality is 2X plus 1Y is less than or equal to 500. The suckers information will provide the second inequality. 2x plus 2y is less than or equal to 600. Part C. Give the inequalities that x and y must satisfy because x and y cannot be negative. We can't have negative suckers, so we want to make sure that our x values and our y values for candy bars and suckers are both positive. Part D. Express the earnings from producing X packages of assortment A and Y packages of assortment B. So the earnings comes from this profit category. 40X plus 30Y, remembering that those are in cents. Step E, graph the feasible set for the packaging problem. We're going to refer to the four inequalities for graphing. The very first inequality was 2x plus y is less than or equal to 500. The x-intercept is 250. The y-intercept is 500. You decide which side of the line to shade by putting in 0, 0. The ordered pair, 0, 0 for x and y, we see it gives us a true statement, so we know we're shading to the left of the line. The next inequality was 2x plus 2y is less than or equal to 600. The x-intercept is 300, as is the y-intercept. Using the test point of 0, 0, you can see that we get a true statement. So we would be shading down and to the left. Our feasible region must be in the first quadrant because we know our x value must be greater than 0 and our y value must be greater than or equal to 0. So we end up with a polygon, a four-sided polygon contained by the x-axis, the two lines, and the y-axis.